वेलकम टू दिस सेशन ऑफ एनर्जी कंजर्वेशन एंड मैनेजमेंट। माई सेल्फ अनिर्बान सरकार, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन मेकानिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट, जे आई एस कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, कल्याणी, वेलकमिंग ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर दिस सेशन। टुडेज सेशन वी विल डिस्कस क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ वेस्ट हीट सोर्सेस एंड रिलेटेड रिकवरी अपॉर्चुनिटीज। So let's start the session. The different flue gas sources are where the source and quality of the heat we can get from the different sources are is given in the following table. First case, heat in flue gases. It is a high temperature remain in the flue gases, it has greater potential value for heat recovery. Heat in vapor stream, it is also quality, that is higher the temperature, we can get the greatest potential value for heat recovery, but when condensed, the latent heat also recovered. Convective and radiant heat lost from exterior of equipments. Quality is low grade, if collected, may be used for space heating or air preheats. Heat losses in cooling water, that is also low grade, comes under useful gains if heat is exchanged with incoming fresh water. Heat losses in providing chilled water or in disposals of chilled water, it will be high grade if it can be utilized to reduce demand for refrigeration. It can be used as a low grade if refrigeration unit used as a form of heat pump. Number 6, heat stored in products leaving the process. Its quality depend upon the temperature. Number 7, heat in gaseous and liquid effluents leaving process. Poor if heavily contaminated and thus required alloy heat exchanger to recover the heat. Next, there are some typical waste heat temperature at high temperature range from various sources are available. Nickel refining furnace, it is high temperature device where the flue gas is exist at 1370 degree centigrade to 1650 degree centigrade. Aluminium refining furnace, it is as high as 650 to 760 degree centigrade. Zinc refining furnace, temperature ranges 760 to 1100 degree centigrade. Copper refining furnace, that is also 760 to 815 degree centigrade. Steel heating furnace, 925 to 1050 degree centigrade. Copper reverberatory furnace, 900 to 1100 degree centigrade. Open hearth furnace, 650 to 700 degree centigrade. Dry process, cement clean, temperature ranges 620 to 730 degree centigrade. Glass melting furnace, 1000 to 1550 degree centigrade. Hydrogen plants, 650 to 1000 degree centigrade. Solid waste incinerators, 650 to 1000 degree centigrade. Fume incinerators, 650 to 1450 degree centigrade. So these are the typically high heat temperature sources of waste heat from the various processes. If we can utilize this heat through waste heat recovery devices, so we can maximize the fuel economy. Next, there are some medium temperature ranges of waste heat recovery sources that is also very important, as because from this part also some waste heat we can recover through various devices and we can ultimately utilize the other purposes. As a result, the fuel economy will get. Now, from a steam boiler exhaust, temperature ranges 230 to 480 degree centigrade. That is, in a steam boiler exhaust, the temperature is as high as 230 to 480 degree centigrade, which is at high temperature. So we can use this heat for the useful purposes through recovery devices. Gas turbine exhaust is also comes under as a medium temperature range waste heat sources. Its temperature 370 to 540 degree centigrade. Reciprocating engine exhaust 315 to 600 degree centigrade. Reciprocating engine exhaust, if it is has turbochargers, then the temperature range will be 230 to 370 degree centigrade. Heat treating furnace 425 to 650 degree centigrade. Drying and baking ovens, that is 230 to 600 degree centigrade. Catalytic cracker 425 to 650 degree centigrade. As well as aluminium furnace cooling system, also temperature range of 425 to 650 degree centigrade. So these are the typical waste heat temperature at medium temperature range sources, where through waste heat recovery devices we can maximize the economy of fuel, as well as the we can maximize the use of this heat as an waste heat. Next, the typical waste heat temperature at low temperature heat recovery. So that low temperature heat recovery usually not practical to extract work from the source, though steam production may not be completely excluded if there is a need for low pressure steam. Low temperature heat waste may be useful in a supplementary way for preheating purposes. So as the temperature range of the low temperature various heat recovery sources are relatively lower temperature range, so it is not practically useful, but if it is we can use as a supplementary way of preheating purposes of different process, whether it is fuel firing, whether it is warming of feed water, etc., that is economical. Now some process steam condense that temperature may as high as 55 to 88 degree centigrade. So if we can use to some extent of this heat, so that it will be beneficial. Cooling water from furnace door, that temperature ranges from 32 to 55. Bearings 32 to 88. Welding machine 32 to 88 degree centigrade. Injection molding machine 32 to 88 degree centigrade. Annealing furnace, it may be as high as 66 degree centigrade to 230 degree centigrade. Forming dies 27 to 88 degree centigrade. Air compressor 27 to 50 degree centigrade. Pumps 27 to 88 degree centigrade. Internal combustion engine, cooling water exhaust, that is 66 to 120 degree temperature varies. Air conditioning and refrigeration condenser, that is 32 to 43 degree centigrade. Liquid steel condenser, that is 32 to 88 degree centigrade varies. And drying, baking and curing ovens, that is also exit temperature, sources of exit temperature 93 to 230 degree centigrade varies, and hot process liquid 32 to 232 degree centigrade temperatures are available, and hot process solids, that is also 93 to 232 degree centigrade temperatures of these sources are varies. So if we can use to some extent in this low temperature range, as we have divided into the typical heat sources, waste heat sources at high, medium and low temperature. So through this, we can maximize the fuel economy and we can use this useful heat at various processes, for ultimately we are gaining and saving the fuel economy, and ultimately we are saving the environment also. Next, we know that there is a thermodynamic limitations, that by which the lower temperature of any process or any engine, by lowering that temperature, there are some limitations are there. In ambient, if we lower the ambient temperature, if we set, so the heat will not flow and ultimately the device will not work. So there are some factors, that is maximum efficiency for power generation, that is Carnot efficiency. Although Carnot is an hypothetical cycle, through this we will understand that if Carnot's engine is possible for a certain temperature ranges of high heat sources and heat rejection temperature, through this also Carnot cycle also we will see that there will be losses. So heat source at different temperature have varying theoretical efficiency limits for power generation. Maximum efficiency at a given temperature is based on Carnot efficiency. So Carnot efficiency is given, that is eta is equal to 1 minus TL by TH, where TH is the waste heat temperature and TL is the temperature of the heat sink. It is typically the atmosphere. So we cannot reduce the sink temperature lower than the atmospheric temperature, other than the heat will not flow from the devices. So ultimately the device will not be effective. This Carnot efficiency represents the maximum possible efficiency of an engine at a given temperature. The Carnot efficiency increases for higher temperature and drops dramatically for lower temperature. So as high as the higher temperature of the heat sources, there is a possibility of the equipment or device efficiency. It may be engine, it may be waste recovery devices. As we cannot change the lower temperature, that is the heat sink temperature, because that is the fixed and that is the ambient temperature max to some extent and slightly higher than the ambient temperature, other than the heat will not flow from the device to the ambient sink. Now it is shown, that is variation of Carnot efficiency of an heat engine, which is a function of, that is temperature difference. So as we can see, that is if temperature difference between the sources and heat sink, that is varies from, that is 0 to 2500 degree Fahrenheit, and Carnot efficiency is also as high as nearly 80%. So Carnot efficiency, through this we can understand that is ultimately heat must be rejected, otherwise it will be the violations of the law, that is thermodynamics law. So in a device actually which is lower than the Carnot efficiency, so the actual efficiency of the device is lower than the Carnot efficiency. So it is can expressed, that is some percentage of the Carnot efficiency. So generally, typically for an engine which is running at petrol engine or diesel engine, which is running at its highest level, its highest efficiency may be around 35 to 40%. In a power plant, single thermal power plant, coal thermal power plant, its efficiency may vary 30 to 35%. Although in the temperature limits, if we put the Carnot cycle efficiency, it may be as high as 45 to 60%. But due to the limitations of the practical and the Carnot engine, that lowers actual from the Carnot cycle. Next, that is, since the temperature of waste heat has a dramatic impact on the feasibility of heat recovery, it is important that assessment of waste heat opportunity considers both waste heat quality and quantity. So this report, we analyze the quantity of waste heat lost from different process, but we also analyze the work potential in order to account for variations in waste heat temperatures. The work potential represents the maximum possible work that could be extracted from a heat engine operating between the waste heat temperature and ambient temperature. This is calculated by multiplying the waste heat by the Carnot efficiency, where Wp is the work potential of the heat sources. So that is calculated by multiplying the waste heat by the Carnot efficiency, where Wp is the work potential of the heat sources. Now, this waste heat lost to the environment, that is T0, eta is the Carnot efficiency, and we know that TH is the temperature of the waste heat sources, and T0 is the ambient temperature, that is sets as generally 25 degree centigrade, or in some cases, it may be as high as 40 degree centigrade. Now, next is waste stream composition. In waste stream composition, although chemical composition do not directly influence the quality or quantity of the available heat, the composition of steam affects the recovery process and material selection. The composition and phase of waste heat streams will determine factors such as thermal conductivity and heat capacity, which will impact heat exchanger effectiveness. Meanwhile, the process-specific chemical makeup of gases will have an important impact on heat exchanger design, material constraints, and cost. Heat transfer rates in heat exchangers are depends on composition and phase of waste heat stream, as well as influenced by deposition of any fouling substance on the heat exchanger. Denser fluid have higher heat transfer coefficient, which enables higher heat transfer rate per unit area of a given temperature difference. Now, the general range of heat transfer coefficient for sensible heat transfer in tubular heat exchangers are given. That is, generally fluid conditions, that is water in liquid case, so heat transfer coefficient in that case, it will be varies from 5 into 10 to the power 3 watt per meter square degree Kelvin to 1 into 10 to the power 4 watt per meter square degree Kelvin. Like light organics liquid, it heat transfer coefficient differs from 1.5 into 10 to the power 3 to 2 into 10 to the power 3 watt per meter square degree Kelvin. Gas, as we know, that it has an effect of pressure. So in generally in atmospheric pressure, it heat transfer coefficient 2 into 5 2.5 into 10 to the power 2 to 4 into 10 to the power 2 watt per meter square degree Kelvin. And gas at high pressure relatively, that is varies from, sorry, gas at relatively low pressure, that is only 100 to 200 kPa, that is 8 into 10 into 1.2 into 10 to the power 2 watt per meter square degree Kelvin. Now another criteria that is given, that is temperature and material selection. The temperature of waste heat sources also an important for material selection in heat exchanger and recovery system. Corrosion and oxidation reaction, like all chemical reaction, are accelerated dramatically by temperature increases. If the waste heat source contains corrosive substance, heat recovery surface can quickly become damaged. And in addition, carbon steel at temperature above 424 degree centigrade and stainless steel above 650 degree centigrade begin to oxidize. Therefore, advanced alloy or composition material must be used at high temperature ranges. Metallic material are usually not used at high temperature of generally 850 degree centigrade above. Alternative includes either bleeding dilution air into the exhaust gases to lower the exhaust temperature, or using ceramic material that can better withstand the high temperature. So in the case of air bleeding, the quantity of heat contained in the exhaust steam remain constant, but the quality is reduced due to temperature. Another key consideration is the interaction between chemicals in the exhaust steam and heat exchanger material. Fouling is a common problem in heat exchanger and can substantially reduce heat exchanger effectiveness or causes system failure. So in the following figure displays an abundant recuperator previously used in the aluminium melting furnace. Deposition of substance on the heat exchanger surface can reduce heat transfer rate as well as inhibit fluid flow in the heat exchanger. In other cases, it will degrade the heat exchanger such that it can no longer be used. Methods for addressing fouling are numerous and include filtering contaminant stream, constructing the exchanger with advanced material, increasing heat exchanger surface area, and designing the heat exchanger for easy access and cleaning. Next is minimum allowable temperature. The minimum allowable temperature for waste heat stream is often closely connected with material corrosion problem. Depending on the fuel used, combustion related flue gases contains various concentrations of carbon dioxide, water vapor, NOx, SOx, unoxidized organics and minerals. If exhaust gas are cooled below dew point temperature, the water vapor in the gas will condense and deposit corrosive substance on the heat exchanger surface. Heat exchanger designed from low cost material will quickly fall due to the chemical attack. Therefore, Heat exchangers are generally designed to maintain exhaust temperature above the condensation point. The minimum temperature for preventing corrosion depends on the composition of fuel. For example, exhaust gas from natural gas might be cooled as low as 120 degrees centigrade, while exhaust gas from coal or fuel oil with higher sulfur content may be limited to 150 degrees centigrade to 175 degrees centigrade. Minimum exhaust temperature may also be constrained by process-related chemicals in exhaust stream. For example, sulfates in exhaust gases from glass melting furnace will deposit on heat exchanger surface at temperature below 270 degrees centigrade. The most common method for preventing chemical corrosion is designing heat exchanger with exhaust temperature well above the dew point temperature. However, there are some cases where heat exchangers use advanced alloy and composition material to further recover low temperature heat. These systems have not seen much commercial application due to challenges such as high material cost, large surface area required for heat exchanger, and lack of available end use for low temperature waste heat. Next, that is economics of scale, accessibility, and other factors. Several additional factors can determine whether heat recovery is feasible in a given application or not. For example, small scale operations are less likely to install heat recovery since sufficient capital may not be available, and because payback period may be longer. Operating schedule can also become a concern if a waste heat source is only available for a limited time every day. The heat exchanger may be exposed to both high and low temperatures. In this case, one must ensure that the heat exchange material does not fatigue due to thermal cycling. Additionally, it is important that the schedule for the heat source match the schedule for the heat load. If not, additional system may be required to provide heat when the waste heat source is not available. Another concern is the ease of access to waste heat sources. In some cases, the physical constraint created by equipment arrangement prevent easy access to the heat source or prevent the installation of any additional equipment for recovering the heat. Additionally, constraints are present by the transportability of heat streams. Hot liquid streams in process industries are frequently recovered since they are easily transportable. Piping system are easy to tap into the energy can be easily transported via piping to the recovery equipment. In contrast, hot solid steam, that is ingots, casting, cement, clinker, can contain significant amount of energy, but their energy is not easily accessible or transportable to recovery equipment. As a result, waste energy recovery is not widely practiced with hot solid materials. So with this, we'll like to conclude this session. Thank you for joining this session.